They retrace the steps immortalized in the biblical account of Moses and his journey to the Promised Land. But in modern times, the journey for Eritrean immigrants and refugees ends in suffering and despair. Waiting for these refugees throughout the Sinai Desert lurks the danger of being kidnapped or even killed by Bedouin traffickers. Dr. Alga Fesaha has witnessed their suffering firsthand.
They have a nightmare. Sometimes they cry. Sometimes they get up in the night and they shout and all these things. So it's a horrible, horrible life, even after that.
In her words, they go through hell. Human and organ trafficking has become a booming and lucrative business in the Sinai. But it's not just the Bedouins, scrupulous smugglers, and even security forces that turned a blind eye take part. Even so, Dr. Fesaha takes her chances. Several times a year, she travels to the Sinai to rescue kidnapped immigrants and those jailed by security forces. The risk is massive.
They will kill us, definitely. They will kill them and they will kill me. I hope it will never happen, but I have to do it because I have to rescue this human being. They are human beings. Actually, they are my people.
Their reason to leave are many: poverty, hunger, and oppressive military regime. But even for the people that don't fall prey to traffickers, reaching Israel or Europe is no guarantee for an easier life.
They come here seeking freedom, rights, and protection, but often what they find doesn't match their expectations.
Overcrowded shelters or long bureaucratic processes have become a norm. One has to look at Lampedusa in Italy. At that point, Don Musa Zerai says their faith sees them through. Both Don Zerai and Dr. Fesaha are advocates for change. They say establishing humanitarian corridors and reforming the asylum process to make it easier can help prevent deaths. But in the meantime, awareness is their best tool.
If people don't know, if institutions aren't informed, they can't intervene.
For her part, Dr. Fesaha continues planning her next mission. In past visits to the Sinai, she's managed to rescue dozens of people. They are then placed in the care of the United Nations and resettled. But her help can only go so far. She recognizes that until there's some real change, the death toll for Sinai trafficking victims and even those in the Mediterranean will continue at a steady pace.